He and Rob were standing out in front of the builder's house, talking to the three-man delegation from Silver Hills. I'm good friends with several of the county commissioners, and one of them told me about their decision. A few of them aren't too excited about Barnes even being the interim sheriff. That's why they want a special election so quickly, in hopes he won't be elected. Do they have someone in mind to run against him? Ralph asked. Not yet, but they hope someone will step up to the plate. Barnes and his uncle still have a lot of influence around here. On the other hand, there are just as many people who don't like their heavy-handed tactics. If the right person was to run, I think they could beat old Barney. Why are you asking? Are you thinking about running, Ralph? The volume of Ralph's laughter was somewhere between a grizzly bear's roar and a clap of thunder. Me? No, I'm just a humble lawyer, not lawman. Everyone laughed. When they stopped laughing, the big lawyer's face turned from jovial to dead serious. He looked right at Rob. Actually, Mark dragged us over here to talk you into doing it, Rob, since you were a cop before. We think you'd make a great sheriff. You're crazy, Ralph exclaimed. I got out of the cop business because of politics. Now you want me to become a politician? That's what a sheriff is, you know, a politician first and peace officer second. Thanks, but no thanks. Rob, if you don't do it, who will? Mark said rhetorically. I understand how you feel, but we need you. Barney's not interested in doing what's best for the citizens of this county. He's only in it for his own benefit. Kurt seemed to find a way to be a peace officer first. I'm sure you could, too. Mark, Kurt was a long-time resident of this county. Everyone knew him and respected him. Some didn't like him, but they still respected him. He was one of a kind. I only moved here a couple years ago. No one really knows me. Even if I could beat Barney, and trust me, nothing would please me more. I still couldn't do the things Kurt could do. People just naturally followed his lead. There's going to be a big power struggle in county government, no matter who ends up being the new sheriff. That's a tough enough under normal circumstances, but with the situation as it is since the burst, it could be tragic. Kurt's primary goal the last several weeks was making sure FEMA stayed out of our business, something he was able to do not only because he knew how to let the federal bureaucrats think they were choosing to leave us alone, but also because everyone here in county government showed solidarity with his plans. If you let the feds smell any hint of discord, they'll take that as an open invitation to come in and ride roughshod over us. I hate to say it, but we might be better off if no one challenges Barney. He probably stands the best chance of holding this thing together until the lights come back on. Everyone considered Rob's point of view for a long moment. I'm sorry. I disagree, Mark said. First, I think you could do as well as Kurt did. True, it might not be as easy for you as it was for him, but we'd all help you, however we could. Mark paused a moment for effect. Second, we haven't told you about the meeting we had with Barney this afternoon. Mark went on to tell the Promise Point leaders what the interim sheriff had said earlier. Their faces got redder and redder as they listened. When Mark got to the part about the rifles that Barnes wanted back, Rob could hold back his anger no more. That rat bastard, he spat. I'll do it. I'll run against him just to piss him off. Good. We've only got 3 weeks until the election, so what do we need to do?